Yeah, my accommodation was an interesting situation. So obviously because I had come from, so their promoter, he typically will fly, because in Asia flights are quite cheap to fly from, you know, Thailand to Hong Kong isn't nearly as expensive as New Zealand to Hong Kong. And then they're also, New Zealand is obviously a lot further. So we managed to get me on the card, one of my managers over in Asia at the time, Eddie Tongalahi, good, recommend him. He got me on the card, and that was no problem. And they flew me over sort of 3 or 4 days. I think it was 4 days or 5 days before the event. But the promoter didn't want to pay for the fancy hotel for the whole 5 days I was there. So he only wanted to pay for 2 days, because he's used to paying for everyone else for 2 days. So for the first 3 days, I stayed in just a brothel, you know, in the middle of just Hong Kong, just some place in a brothel. And that was an interesting experience. You know, I had a lot of fun that trip. That was one of the highlights of all my international flight trips. Yeah, staying in a brothel, though, I text my wife, I think I was talking to her on the phone. I was like, oh, by the way, I'm staying in a brothel. And she was like, what? She's like, can you come home? I'm like, I'm kind of here to do work. You know, I'm here for a couple of days. There's really good Wi-Fi, at least. So, you know, there's that. But then other than that, because it was a brothel, I spent most of the time out walking about the streets of Hong Kong. So that was cool, because I got to see a lot more of Hong Kong than I would have if I was stuck in a hotel room.